Hello, sir. Welcome to my suit shop. Today, you are getting a very personal experience. I will be fitting you, as well as showing you the selections that I have. We're going to be looking through my new catalog and picking out a couple of suits that I think to find my shop, okay? A little bit difficult, right? Yes, we're a little bit tucked away here. It's not the best location for window shoppers or general foot traffic, but I find it's an intimate location for providing a more special In fact, people who have wanted to visit me have said that they can't find the shop during certain hours of the day, and I believe it's always when I'm having an appointment with a very special client, such as yourself. Okay. Alright, so let me take off your hats. Okay. I'll be very careful. Fine hat, a dunicle tweed, straight from Ireland. I will keep this safe and protected, okay? How nice. I can tell that you are a man of fine taste. So, I would like to offer you a cup of tea, if you would like. Okay. Yes. Let me serve it up for you. Okay. Here's your tea. I'm going to put it on this table right here. There we go. Okay. Alright. So, I'd like to show you just the different options that we have in this catalog here. Different colors. Cufflink options on these dress shirts. These particular ones are made of a no iron cotton, so they're going to maintain their shape and not get wrinkly very quickly, which is really nice. Cotton is a very comfortable material as well. So we offer button cuffs as well as French cuffs, and as you know, you're going to need some cufflinks with your French cuffs. We have options of mother of pearl cufflinks this summer, which are quite nice and give you the chance to show a little bit of personality with that ornamental flair. Okay. As you can see, we're offering a lot of pastel-y colors this summer. We feel pastel is a very good summer color choice. So, you can see that we have different fit options, of course. Your classic fit is going to be the more baggier type of shirt. Slim fit. And we also have a new tailored fit. And the tailored fit is just sort of going to be in between the slim and the classic. So, give you a little best of both worlds. Okay. Alright. And these shirts come in pinpoint Oxford or broadcloth. And if this is going to be more of a working shirt, I definitely recommend the pinpoint Oxford. It's going to be more durable and not as fancy as the broadcloth. Alright, now I'd like to show you some of the collar options that we have. We have the Windsor spread, that's going to be a bit wider. The points are sort of angled out. It accommodates a larger tie. We have the cutaway spread. Now, this is a very dramatic look. Gives quite a statement, because sometimes the points are even going to be hidden by your lapel if you're wearing a suit jacket with it. I don't particularly recommend this style for a very traditional workplace. It might be a little bit too much of a statement. Okay? This also has the effect of widening the face and giving taller guys more of a wider appearance. So, we also have snap-tab collars. These feature a little bit of a bar in between the collar sections, and that makes it a lot more crisp of a look when you're wearing it with a tie. But you do have to wear it with a tie because there is an element there that would be visible without it. Okay. And we also have your classic straight collar. These are points that are going to be more vertical, pointed down. I will recommend for you the Windsor spread or the straight collar. I think it would be the most flattering with your height. Okay? Yes, there is a difference between the Windsor and the straight. The Windsor was actually specifically designed for the Duke of Windsor, because he liked to wear these very wide knot ties with his suits. So, we also are offering different designs. We have striped shirts. We have twill material shirts. Those are going to be up there with your broadcloth in terms of fanciness. Though twill has more of a shine to it, and it isn't as crisp as broadcloth. But it's very soft. We also have herringbone design. It's more of a subtle herringbone in this particular shirt example down here. Mm-hmm. Herringbone is named after the design. It's kind of like a chevron, but it ends up looking like the bones of a herring fish. Okay. And we also have engravable cufflinks. So if you want to add that little extra personalization, we do that. Okay, so now we're moving on to some pants options. So, all of our pants come unfinished, with an unfinished hem. The hemming is an additional. You have to let us know if you would like it cuffed or standard hem. Okay. Alright. And we also offer some socks. We have Pima cotton socks. Pima cotton is a luxury long fiber cotton that's specifically grown in Peru, and all of our socks are hand knitted in Peru. So you can see some of the designs of our pinpoint Oxford shirts. So you can see a lot of pastels. We can always do standard colors though. So don't feel forced to pick pastel colors if you're not feeling it, okay? These ones have solid color. And on the inside we have different adornments along with it. Gingham with the blue. Tattersall. Grid. Solid as well as an option. More different types of grids. This looks like a grid that is cut on the bodice, and a check as well. Alright, here are some more pattern options. We have alternating stripe, bangle stripe, if you're looking to go for a very Wall Street vibe. I definitely recommend this bangle stripe, very classic. We also have check and tattersall up here. And you can see the different pairings with ties, medallion, angled stripe, paisley, and seahorse right here. My personal favorite. So cute. Alright. So we also have these microfiber pants. We have two different fit options for these pants. We have the standard fit, and we also have the comfort waistband. Yes, microfiber is synthetic, but it has very, very good moisture wicking properties. That's why it's so popular in undergarments as well as a material. Over here, we have a very fine selection of wool sharkskin pants. Sharkskin is a very, very fine material. Yes, if you're looking to give that elevated appearance, I definitely recommend the sharkskin. It has a two-tone appearance to it, so it really shines. On this side, we have another selection, pastel blue and yellow colored shirts with different silk dyes to match with them. Here we have a Glen Plaid. Is named after Glenarket, which is a valley in Inverness, Scotland. And that's where the first time they used this particular design, back I believe in the 19th century. A little fun fact. So you can see a lot of these collars are buttoned down. And then we have some Windsor collars as well as options. Now we can look at some shoes. Hope beer, we have a monk strap shoe. And down here, also monk strap shoe. This one has the cap toe. Monk strap shoes are called that way because monks popularized the style in the Middle Ages. Monks used to do most of their work in sandals, and this was kind of uncomfortable. So they started to transition to kind of a sandal-like shoe with the strap across. And then they became monk strap. So we also have some penny loafers and tassel loafers. Tassel loafers are so named because this leather strap holds the tassel down. Loafers are much more casual shoes. They were originally designed as house shoes, so keep that in mind when picking them out. Penny loafers are so named because students used to slip a penny in this little slit right here, and they'd use that to pay for phone calls or any other expenses students need to use. So these are some derby shoes as well. These were used originally as sporting and hunting shoes, so they're really good, versatile, go-around-town type of shoe. And of course, ultimately the most versatile are going to be the Oxfords. These can be either casual or fancy. For me, a good rule of thumb is the darker and more simpler design of the shoe, the more fancy it's going to be considered. So, go with the plain black Oxford just for your ultimate in fancy class. Alright. So, we also have these gorgeous brown and black wingtip Oxfords. They're called wingtip because these side things sort of resemble wings. They extend past the tip. And then we have some wool gabardine pants. It's a very good material, very good for the winter. These we're considering all season, but generally they're more of a warm weather pant. I'm sorry, a cool weather pant. They'll keep you warm in cool weather. Okay? Alright. Okay. So now we have some more collared shirts. You can see here's that button-down collar that I mentioned earlier. So button-down collars were originally used as a way for polo players to prevent their collar from flying up in their face when they're playing polo. So it's a very functional design. However, you really don't want to be mixing it with your more fancier suits and more formal suits, you know, such as a double-breasted suit. You really wouldn't want to go with the button-down collar with that. So keep in mind that it's just a more casual look overall, okay? So we also have some standard, very bright colored diagonal stripe ties along with these. Windsor spread and your regular straight collar. And these are button cuffed and then French cuffed. And then we also have these matching cufflinks with the ties. Pretty nice to have them matching. Alright, and here we have a couple of neutral options for dress shirts. You can see we're really going with the paisley design for summer on these silk ties. Also the medallion. And your can't go wrong diagonal stripe. And then we have these pants. Again, some very neutral colors. Stone, sleep brown, black, and khaki. Alright, and then on these pants, we're offering pleated, single pleats in the front, or a flat front as well. Up to you which style you want to go with. The more simple or that little extra detail with the pleat, which I personally like quite a bit. We also have loafer socks, so if you're going for the no-show style, I recommend those. So we have a nice selection here of striped button-down collar shirts. They have this additional detail of the bias cut on the trim of the collar. Nice little touch of details. And here we have a woolen cotton blend soft coat. Soft coats are going to be more of a casual style, okay? Just keep that in mind. And we also have a small selection of paisley pocket squares. I feel like pocket squares are a really great way to show your personality. So you don't have to pick out any of the pocket squares that we have, but just keep that in mind when you're searching them up, okay? Alright. This style is paired with the soft twill pants as well, and suede matching belt and shoes. Alright, so now we have some of our suit options here. We have double-breasted suit. Of course, the double-breasted has the peak lapel. We also have single-breasted suits with the peak lapel. The peak lapel can be a little bit more of a flashier style. So if you really want to show a personality, go for the peak lapel. However, I would be more aware of what the styles are in your office setting. So, notch lapel, always a classic, you can't go wrong with it. And you can see it right here. Peak lapel goes well with wide ties as well. Okay. Double-breasted suit, always a great formal style. Not always the most flattering for wider builds, so just keep that in mind. Always want to stick with the feel of the double-breasted suit, matching it with shark skin pants, not jeans or anything like that, okay? Alright. So, what do we have over here? We have another notch lapel, looks like a single-breasted shark skin suit. And also some simple colored pocket squares. We also see the hacking pockets over here on these suits. Those are really good for men of shorter stature. Can give you that sort of vertical line to elevate you a little bit. Okay. Alright. So here we have some more wool shark skin suit options. This is a single-breasted with a double button. The notch lapel. He has a button-down collar shirt and looks like straight across pockets. Also right here we have full-grain leather shoes and belt. Full-grain leather is the most durable. It hasn't been sanded or buffed or anything to remove perfection, so it tends to be very strong material. Okay. Here we have some more button-down collars, shirts. You can see the pairings of the ties and the designs of the shirts. Okay. We also have some more wool suits here. We have suits with options for a center vent in the back, as well as parallel side vents. Whatever you like the best. Single-breasted, double-breasted, peak lapel, notch lapel, whatever you want, we can do it. Okay? We offer suits with matching vests as well. We can do hacking pockets, straight pockets. We're all very good at clean, professional look. Looks like they're both going with the peak lapel on this two options here. Okay. We're also offering some pastel lavender colors this summer. We have floral designs, natural designs, paisley, medallion stripes. You could see a parrot with a brown windowpane suit. Matching paisley pocket square. Here we show some examples of a monochromatic look. We have gingham and check and grid windowpane sort of styles, tattersall, monochrome, Windsor collar, straight collar, snap, button down as well. Looks like they're all going for the button cuff. We have the impeccable suit, and this is French faced on the inside. That's when it's partially lined, typically by the same fabric as the outside. So it's a little bit lighter, perfect sort of suit for the summertime. Has the notch lapel, single breasted. And straight pockets. Alright, now we have your blue options, of course. Got a little polka dot tie as well. And here we have more suit. This one has a ticket pocket. You can see it right here. A ticket pocket was an additional pocket set above your regular pocket. It became very popular in the Industrial Revolution, and it was a common tailor request during that time. Train travel became more popular, and gentlemen needed a separate pocket to put their ticket in, easy access. So that's that right there. One of my favorite little details. Here we have some more casual shoes and shirt options. We have sneakers, moccasins, some more casual Oxfords, example from the formal to now the casual. And you also get that matching belt with it. And we also have these loafers with the matching belt and the moccasins. We also have these flip-flops and polos, mock turtleneck, zip polo, and a long sleeve V-neck, all made from that long fiber Pima cotton. Great material. Here we have some more crew neck and polo shirts. Good vacation styles. We also have these Supima shorts, and that is a United States grown long fiber cotton. Very high quality cotton. I believe only 1% of all cotton grown is Supima cotton. So you know you're getting high quality there. These are dry clean only though, so keep that in mind. Some nice black sneakers with the white bottoms. Alright, and now we're going even more vacation-y. Sort of Hawaiian style casual shirts. Batik prints and made out of cotton fabric. We're also offering this straw fedora. It's made out of natural toyo straw, which is from Japan. There's a sage green band around it. Finally, we have our casual collared shirts. We have the standing collar. This has no turn down to it. And we also have the Cuban or camp collar down here. Much more loose and unstructured fit, so it's really going to keep your neck breezy in the warm weather. You could see an example right here. Okay, so I want to let you think about your selections before we do some ordering. And in the meantime, I'm going to measure your body so we can know how to tailor your suits correctly to your body type and fit, okay? Alright, so let's get to it. I'd like to get started by figuring out your height. Okay. So, you look to be about 5'6". 5'5". Okay. I'm usually pretty close at least. Let's get the rest of your measurements here. I'm going to start by measuring the length of your back from by your shoulders and down to your to take measurement across the top. center. So, this first jacket I'm going to show you here is a tuxedo jacket, as you can tell. We can tell it's a tuxedo jacket because of the contrasting fabric of the lapel. This is a single-breasted, one-button tuxedo jacket. Pocket for your pocket square, and it has straight pockets, but I can also make them hacking as well. It's up to you. I think for your height, we will be using hacking pockets just to give you that vertical line. Some seam detailing here. And on the back, it is singly vented in the center, like that. So, this is just one example. Of a three-button cuff as well to this. These shank buttons. Your standard coat. Suit jacket. We have a regular classic match lapel with a black pocket square, just as an example. This is also single-breasted, and it has two buttons. And this example is again with the straight pockets, and these are flapped. And we see another button cuff, three buttons. And on the back, we are vented at the center. I can also do two side vents if you prefer that look. And again, you will probably be going with the hanging pockets on all of your suit jackets. Just an example. Now, I also have more of a special jacket that I would like to show. This jacket is a 100% herringbone design jacket. It has the notch lapel. It's lined on the inside with silk. Very cool and soft against the body. In the center back. And it's single-breasted with two buttons, two wooden shank buttons, and it has the three-button cuff. Similar to the black suit jacket, but just showing you a different material.